From a desolate prison in Ohio to an empty lighthouse off the shores of Oregon, today we look at unusual abandoned places in the United States. Number 11. Salton Riviera. Amid the deserts of California, just under 60 miles outside of Palm Springs, is the relic of the resort town that never was. Also known as Salton Seaside, Salton City, or American Riviera, this settlement was centered around the city's marina and was advertised in the 1960s as a desert beach oasis. But rising water elevation, a lack of employment opportunities, and dangerous pollution levels in the Salton Sea all led to this city's downfall, as 81% of it remains incomplete and undeveloped. Number 10. Mansfield Reformatory. Also called the Ohio State Reformatory, this famed prison has a whole lot of history. Between 1886 and 1910, the Mansfield Reformatory was built upon a 40-acre property. Originally, this land was used as a training camp during the American military contention for secession in the 1860s. But by the time 1867 rolled around, the region became approved for the location of a new intermediary penitentiary, meant to be a halfway stop between a juvenile detention center and the state penitentiary. The first batch of prisoners to serve time here would assist in its construction, being put to work building the institution's sewer system and 25-foot outer wall. Once it was complete, the prison remained functional and in full use until a decree forced its closure in 1990 due to overcrowding and poor living conditions. Since then, the Mansfield Reformatory has been under rehabilitation and has served as a setting in famous films and other works like Air Force One and The Shawshank Redemption. Number 9. Six Flags New Orleans. Amusement parks are supposed to be fun, vibrant getaways from the real world. And when it opened in 2000 under the name Jazzland, the 140-acre Six Flags New Orleans was just that. With the slogan, "It's Playtime," the park provided visitors with entertainment from attractions like their many DC Comics and Looney Tunes theme rides, plus their Cajun and Mardi Gras-influenced park sections. The success of Six Flags New Orleans inspired expansion as the park planned to open a water park on the property in early 2005. But later that year, disaster struck as Hurricane Katrina obliterated the magical grounds, leaving the park in ruins. Today, Six Flags New Orleans is a decrepit shell of its former self, with the park as a whole determined to be an effective and total loss. The unique condition of this location has drawn the attention of the public and Hollywood alike, with thrill seekers recording video of the park for YouTube and filmmakers using the site for movies like Stolen, Dawn of the Planet of the Apes, and Jurassic World. Number 8. Elkmont Historic District. The Little River Valley in the Great Smoky Mountains of Tennessee's Sevier County is a gorgeous example of the Appalachian wilderness and historically a popular location for hunting and fishing. The area of Elkmont was originally settled by settlers in search of gold, but when a logging company took over the region, the owner opened it up to locals in search of game. As timber in the region ran low and the owner sold much of the land to the Great Smoky Mountains Park Commission, he began transitioning Elkmont Valley into an Appalachian vacation spot. Cottages, cabins, and even a hotel sprouted up in Elkmont, and the small community of buildings would become a resort town. The forest-shrouded residents of the region sought to further protect their slice of paradise after the lumber company up and left. They sparked the movement to establish the Great Smoky Mountains as a national park, but this would cause the settlers to have to sell their property to the government. As their leases ended, Elkmont would become an isolated cabin town, with many of the cottages and clubhouses protected as historical buildings today. Number 7. Cape Romano Dome Home. In the late 1970s, after retiring from the oil business, one man decided to construct his dream vacation home. Purchasing plots of land and a barge to transport supplies and constructing the white concrete structures, he slowly but surely put together his six-dome home on the shores of Caxambas Island in Cape Romano. To prepare for the Florida home, he built a full-scale model on a Tennessee property he owned, the likes of which can still be found today. Eventually, after exchanging hands a couple times, the original designer of the dome home moved in permanently, enjoying the unique tranquil setting and fishing opportunity. But over the years, erosion took its toll and the sea level rose to meet the pillars on which the dome sat. Then Hurricane Wilma hit in 2005, destabilizing the home's foundation. In the years to follow, the coastline would rise and the distance from these decaying homes would continue to increase. As of 2017, thanks to Hurricane Irma, only four of the domes remain intact, now 180 feet away from the land they were once atop. Number 6. Bannerman Castle. A grand structure sits on the Palapel Island of the Hudson River, reminiscent of fortresses from across the Atlantic. The Great Bannerman Castle was originally erected by an Irish immigrant named Francis Bannerman VI as a regal storage space for his burgeoning military surplus business. However, the building stopped construction in 1918 with his passing. 2 years later, more than 200 pounds of ammunition and powder exploded, destroying part of the structure and leaving it in disrepair. Over time, the sale of firearms to the public became more difficult due to state and federal regulations, and with the sinking of the island's serving ferry, the castle and its stockpile became vacant after 1950. Eventually, the state purchased the island, removed the munitions, and began giving tours to the public. But after a fire broke out in 1969, just a year after its reopening, New York designated Bannerman's Castle as off-limits. Today, it remains a popular landmark, though the ruins have been the victim of vandalism and neglect, with portions continuing to collapse periodically. Number 5. Glen Rio Ghost Town. Straddling the border between Quay County, New Mexico, and Deaf Smith County, Texas, is the real-life version of Radiator Springs from Disney's Cars. The quaint town of Glen Rio once served as a popular pit stop along the famous Route 66. It began as a railroad town named Rock Island, but switched to Glen Rio in 1908 and began receiving traveling motorists by 1917. But with the formation of Route 66 in 1926, the small town quickly grew as business picked up heading into the 30s. Glen Rio added multiple filling stations, motels, and dining establishments in both states it occupied to accommodate the increased traffic. However, in 1973, Interstate 40 was installed and completely bypassed the small community, allowing travelers to skip the collection of businesses entirely, just like the fantasy town of Radiator Springs. This relation wasn't lost on filmmakers either, as Pixar animators took road trips across Route 66 in preparation for the film, experiencing the classic highway firsthand. As a result, an Easter egg can be found in Cars paying tribute to this ghost town by way of the Glen Rio Motel, which uses the real-life Little Juarez Cafe in Glen Rio as inspiration. Number 4. Tillamook Rock Lighthouse. Once the most expensive lighthouse ever built on the West Coast, this structure is a gorgeous historical landmark. But time and Mother Nature haven't been too kind to the Tillamook Rock Lighthouse, as the waters off the Oregon coast have thrashed it since its completion in 1881. The hazardous weather and difficult time endured by the lighthouse keepers and suppliers earned the building the nickname Terrible Tilly. The isolated building sits atop a large rock about 1.2 miles off the shore of Tillamook Head, and as such, keepers working here endure hardships in their work. The lighthouse stayed in operation until 1957 due to the extreme cost to upkeep the Great Sea Beacon. Afterwards, it was used for a short time as a columbarium, or a public storage center for urns. But this didn't last long, as the realtors owning it would have their license revoked by the Oregon Mortuary and Cemetery Board. Today, it remains hard to access, with helicopter transport the only sure way to get there. In addition to being a nationally registered historical place, the Tillamook Rock Lighthouse is also part of the Oregon Islands National Wildlife Refuge, with the seabirds of the region being protected from disturbance during nesting season. Number 3. Hudson River State Hospital. In upstate New York, at the town of Poughkeepsie, the massive grounds of the Hudson River State Hospital have stood tall since its initial construction in 1871. This structure is a National Historic Landmark, thanks to its high Victorian Gothic architecture, a unique style and the first of its kind among American institutions. 15 separate buildings make up the hospital grounds, many of which were built after the institution's initial launch, and the property itself is 296 acres. But as progress was made in the psychiatric field, less and less patients required being committed to mental health facilities such as this. As patient numbers dropped, so went the general maintenance, and the buildings would begin falling into disrepair. It wasn't until 2003 that the hospital as a whole finally closed. Since then, it's endured fire damage and deterioration, creating a haunting setting for interested tourists. Number 2. The Domes of Casa Grande. Strange domes and tunnels sit just outside of the Arizona town of Casa Grande. These odd buildings once belonged to a circuit board manufacturer called Intercon Technology, and this site was meant to be their new headquarters upon construction in 1983. But when the company went under, and the Union of California assumed ownership that same year, they would remain incomplete and abandoned to this day. Since then, a number of rumors regarding the desert oddities have arisen. Some of these rural legends include the presence of portals that can apparently lead to alternate dimensions, the site acting as a medium for summoning demons, and the rumor of rituals which resulted in souls being trapped there. In reality, though, these domes are barely staying aloft as they crumble and decay, now covered in graffiti. The Casa Grande domes have been deemed a safety hazard, and as such are no longer widely open to the public. Number 1. Kennecott Mines. From 1906 to 1938, this U.S. National Historic Landmark was operational and one of the richest producers of copper ore in the world. These mines churned out over 1 billion pounds of copper during their use, but in the 33 years, they eventually ran dry. The mills of the Kennecott Mines, which were named for the glacier that sits in the Alaskan Valley below them, are still standing today, but only as a tourist destination for curious hikers.